The accommodation reflex is tested in routine neurological examination by asking the patient to examine an object held about a foot from the eyes after looking in the distance, then noting whether or not there is pupillary constriction. Accommodation reflex is needed for near vision, for which 3 ocular adjustments are required and will happen. First is pupillary constriction to sharpen the image on the retina for the near vision, and then convergence of the optic axis for the same purpose by stimulating the medial rectus muscle, and then increased convexity of the lens to increase its refractive power. This means that the accommodation reflex requires image analysis. Thus, the cerebral cortex must be involved, as we will see in a moment, in the reflex pathway. This chart shows the pupillary light reflex pathway. I will superimpose the accommodation reflex pathway, and you will notice that the accommodation reflex pathway in its initial part is common with the light reflex. It starts from retinal ganglion cells that will send impulses through the optic nerve, optic chiasma, and then optic tract. Instead of taking a detour and going to the pretectal area, most of the fibers of the optic tract, in fact, they will synapse in the lateral geniculate nucleus of the thalamus. From the lateral geniculate nucleus, second-order neurons will carry the impulses through the optic radiation to the visual cortex. The visual cortex is not required for the light reflex pathway, but because accommodation reflex requires image analysis, the cerebral cortex must be involved, as we mentioned earlier. Impulses from the visual cortex will pass to the prefrontal cortex, from which fibers pass through the internal capsule to reach the midbrain. The fibers in the midbrain will synapse with the oculomotor nucleus and with the Edinger-Westphal nucleus. Motor fibers carried by the oculomotor nerve supply the medial rectus muscle and cause convergence of both eyes. The efferent part from the Edinger-Westphal nucleus, which is the parasympathetic autonomic nucleus, efferent fibers are in fact preganglionic parasympathetic fibers. They accompany the oculomotor nerve and synapse in the ciliary ganglion. Postganglionic fibers arising from the ciliary ganglion pass with the short ciliary nerves to supply the constrictor pupillae muscle, same as in case of the light reflex. But here in the accommodation reflex, these postganglionic fibers supply, in addition to constrictor pupillae, they supply the ciliary muscle, which allows the lens to thicken. Therefore, the 3 requirements to fulfill the need for the accommodation reflex are achieved: pupillary constriction to sharpen the image on the retina, convergence of the optic axis, and increased convexity of the lens to increase the refractive power. As you see here in the superimposed diagram between the accommodation and light reflexes, the pathway in its initial part is common for both, so as in its terminal part. But the pathway for the light reflex dissociates and passes to the pretectal area in parts of its course. Now, because the central connections of light and accommodation reflexes are different, they may be dissociated by disease. In Argyle-Robertson pupil, there is no pupillary constriction in response to light reflex, but pupillary constriction can still happen in response to accommodation reflex. This takes place because of the central dissociation of these reflexes, and in central nervous system syphilis, where Argyle-Robertson pupil can be observed, there is loss of pupillary constriction to light, but not accommodation, because of the involvement of the pretectal area. The pretectal area is part of the pupillary light reflex, but it is not part of the accommodation reflex. So, if this area is abolished, there will be no pupillary constriction in response to light, but pupillary constriction can still happen through the accommodation reflex, because the accommodation reflex does not require the presence of the pretectal area in order to complete the pathway that results in constriction of the pupil.